If you want to light up your model railroad and you're on a budget, you're going to want to watch this. In a previous video, I showed you how to use an Arduino Nano to light up your model railroad. Now, I'm going to show you what wires you could use on there and the LEDs that you could use on there. I have some other videos that are related to this, as far as soldering SMD LEDs and taking apart a wall wart, which is a big part of this video right here. So let's get started with it right now. In another video, I tore apart a wall wart. We got these wires from there. It's called magnet wire. And you got two coils inside. The one coil, it is like hair thin, which is no good for what we need on here. But this other coil of wire is approximately 24 gauge wire, and it's nice and strong. The only thing is you have to scrape off the insulation on here. Now, I did the video on it about tearing apart the AC wall warts. You may have different size wires on your wall wart coils based on the voltage of the wall wart, so keep that in mind. You could find very inexpensive wall warts at your local thrift store. I got mine for about 50 cents a piece. Now, what I'm using here is the magnet wire on there for the SMD LEDs. And here's one that I already made up, and I scratched off the ends of it. But let me show you how we work this here. What I do is measure out about 12 inches of it. I just set it up over here and cut off just a little bit over 12 inches, about 12 and a half inches. And what we have to do is scrape the edges of it to get the insulation off of it. Now, this is, it's kind of hard to get off. And I do it two different ways. I use the X-Acto blade, and you got to turn this thing over to get both sides of it and try to get as many angles on it as you can. Like this, turn it just a little bit that way, and then turn it back this way. And then these fingernail files, Dollar Tree, you get a whole stack of them for a dollar. And you could, what I do is just turn it in there, hold two of them together, and just use the sandpaper on there to clean it off a little. And this usually does the trick on there. And then you do the other side the same way. Scrape it off with the X-Acto blade. Now, they do make magnet wire where you don't have to scrape off the insulation. And I'm going to show you that in a little bit here, that I bought some. It comes from the manufacturer's Remington. And I showed you on a previous video me soldering a 30 gauge wire to the SMD LEDs. Well, I just purchased some 24 gauge wire, and it's about $7 for 100 foot of it, and you can get it in, you know, different footage rolls, but I got about 100 foot of it for $7, and I'll show you that next. But the coating on the wire is actually flux. When it melts, it's actually flux, so when you put the iron up against it, it melts, turns into flux, and then you could solder your wires together. Okay, so let's get the meter over here. Okay, that's this one here. So what I do is I just take the meter on both ends of this to make sure. We'll put it on the audible and see, we got continuity on there, but not very good. We could maybe this end right here. Yeah, this end right here, maybe we could do a little bit more work on it. So just come over here with the sandpaper and just hit it a couple more times until, okay, that's good right there. So that's what we do with the wire. We do both of them and then we twist them together. Now that we got the two wires ready, all we need to do is just twist them together a little bit. Now, I've seen people do this in a drill, but you don't want to get it too tight. I mean, you could do it in a drill, but it's going to make it really tight. So I just come down and I just twist it together like this. And that's all you need, just to hold the two wires together. Okay. And there we go. I got two more of these. And I'll show you what I did so far with these other ones. I made up four of them and I got the SMD LEDs on there. And then on the other end, what I did was tested them, and the wire that I used for these other ones that I have, these ones right here, I soldered wire on the end of them. I soldered wire on the end of these right here, and this is heat shrink on this. It's black and yellow heat shrink because the insulation from the black wire won't go over that. But I used the insulation from the black wire on here, just slid it over top of the negative lead. So whenever we go to hook this up, I know which lead is negative. And if I have to cut this shorter, we'll just strip it down a little bit and scrape it like we did the other one, and then just take the insulation and move it down to where we need it. But this is what we're going to be using on the buildings. We're going to be using the SMD LEDs on here. Now these are warm. I think these are warm white that I showed you in another video. And all these things that I'm showing you here, I did in another video at one point or another. Now I'm putting them into use in the buildings. And this type right here is going to be the kind that I use for the arc welder. It's a real small one, and actually it's coated. So what I did was I cut the coating off of it. But that's another video right there. But this one here, we're going to make up about 12 of these. So that's what we have so far. We have to work on a little bit more of the wiring. And let me show you the Remington wire that is ready to solder. Now here's a spool of the Remington wire that I was telling you about. It's 26 gauge. And you can see it's red. It comes in assorted colors, and it's magnet wire. And like I said before, all you have to do is heat this up, and the insulation that is coating this is actually flux. So you don't need flux when you're soldering it to your SMD LEDs. And it comes in different gauges. I showed you on a previous video I use some 30 gauge, but I bought this 26 gauge here. It's a little bit heavier. I got this at Amazon, and I think you can order directly from Remington too. I'm not quite sure, but I got it through Amazon. When I get it through Amazon, I get it a lot quicker. These LEDs right here are from something that I got at Michael's. There was a long string of a series of LEDs, and they had a little box where you could put a battery in there and they flash and do all kind of things. You buy these after Christmas and you can get them for a couple of bucks. These are the LEDs that I used on my welding sketch that I have right back here. But anyway, on here I soldered a little bit heavier wire on it because this is kind of flimsy wire on it. It's maybe 28 gauge or so. So I put 22 gauge wire on the bottom of it. I soldered on it. And then like I said before, I put the shrink wrap on it. And you can get this at spools of this. I have six different colors of it. I got it at Adafruit. You can get it anywhere. I think they have them at Amazon also. It's a good thing to have. This is solid wire. You could also get stranded wire, but I preferred solid wire for this because you could easily put this, and this is why I did it, because you could push these into the breadboard real easily. If you recall, the SMD LEDs come in a little tape like this right here, and all you do is just remove the cover on there and be careful with it, because there's some LEDs in the carpet someplace that, you know, bounced off of here and then went down there and I never found. But anyway, be careful with it. You just take them off one by one. Just peel this thing back whenever you need a LED and just drop it onto your workbench. But you get 100 of them for $6. And I bought another package of them. This one is warm white, and this just is plain white, so I could vary the colors on there. And you could also take some acrylic paint and put a light coating on there to change the color if you need to change the color on these things. And I'll show you how to do that in it later on. Here's the packaging of those, like teardrop, they're called rice lights. They're originally $7.99, but I got them at Michael's after Christmas, not this past Christmas, but the year before, for about a couple of bucks. They're very inexpensive after Christmas. And if you're intimidated by SMD lights, I got these at Walgreens after Christmas. I finally got them about $2 a box. So for 50 LEDs, $2 for 50 LEDs, and I already disassembled one of them. You know, it's the Christmas tree lights, and all you do is just remove the LEDs from the string. It's a little work, and you'll notice on about every four or five of them there'll be a little resistor on each one of the LEDs, but you could use these anywhere, and I've used these in projects already, and so I have about 200 clear LEDs that cost me $8. And then these right here were $2. I got two packages. I used one package already, and here's the other one. And inside here, there's a little battery pack that you could also use that for lighting up something that's remote. If you just want to do it every once in a while, you put some batteries in it, turn the switch on. You got 5 volts for your lighting. If you're intimidated by the SMD lights, you can get these after Christmas. Or you can get a whole package of assorted colors for about $7 on Amazon, and I have the link down in the description. I've used those too. Here you go, you get them in a nice little thing, and I think there's 200 LEDs in there of assorted colors. You got clear, red, blue, green, yellow. Now, I showed you in a previous video that we're using the Nano on a circuit board, and I'm using a DF player mini on it, but you don't have to do that if you don't want sound associated with your building lights. But you could do it with a Nano, and you could get about three of the Nanos. I got three of these Nanos for about $11 on Amazon. Or if you prefer something larger, Elegoo, you get the Uno, And I got this, I think it was about 10 bucks on Amazon for the Arduino Uno. And it just like the Arduino Uno, but less expensive. But I've had pretty good luck with everything from Arduino. These Nanos are from Arduino also. So take a look into that. That's a very inexpensive way to light up your model railroad with the wall wart wire, or if you prefer not to work so hard, you can get this from Remington and you don't have to scratch off all the insulation on the wall wart wire. But anyway, you could put it on a circuit board like this. You could use these connectors, or if you don't want to, you could solder the wires directly on here. You put your resistors on here. But on future ones, I'm going to use all SIP resistors on there instead of using the regular resistors on there for the LEDs. As usual, everything that I talk about in my videos, if there's a link or anything else, you could find that in the description. And sometimes if it's a video, you'll see it in the info boxes up there. So, until the next time, we'll see you.